Hello everyone, in this lecture video, I am going to talk about HDFS components. I have made two parts of HDFS components. Part 1 is already been uploaded, and in this part 2 lecture video, I will be talking about HDFS namespace federation, HDFS checkpoints and HDFS snapshots, which comes under HDFS components. And the first topic in today's lecture video is HDFS namespace federation. Let me tell you what is namespace. Namespace is like a container where it contains the metadata of all files and directories. This namespace is actually managed by name node. Each name node will have its own namespace where it have metadata of all files and directories. Now we'll see what is namespace federation. In HDFS name node federation, it adds support for multiple name nodes or namespaces to the HDFS file system, as against the earlier versions which has only a single name node managing the entire cluster. Meaning, in previous versions, we could have only one name node to manage the entire cluster. But in version 2 and all, where we can have more than one name node, and each name node maintains its own namespace in the HDFS cluster. In this federation means where you can have more than one name node. So when you have more than one name node, where you can have more than one namespace, because each name node maintains its own namespace. So it will be easy for us to perform more operations. So that is the main use of namespace federation. Now we'll see what are the benefits of namespace federation. The first benefit of federation is namespace scalability. Second one, better performance. And third one, system isolation. So what is this namespace scalability? So here in this federation, as I told you, where you can have more than one name node, more than one namespace. So this cluster, HDFS cluster, it scales horizontally like this. If you see in the diagram, you have more than one name node. So it's scaling horizontally. So it scales horizontally without placing any burden on the cluster. So the scalability of namespace is use of this federation. And the second benefit is better performance. So since we have multiple name nodes in the cluster, it improves the system throughput, meaning where you can perform more than one operation, you can perform more read and write operations because we have more than one name node. So the throughput will be increased. And the third benefit is system isolation. So here, since we have different name nodes and different namespaces, so different users can be isolated to different namespaces with the help of multiple name node. This is a simple example of HDFS name node federation, where in this example you can see here we have two name nodes, that is name node 1 and name node 2. Each name node having its own namespace. This name node 1 having namespace 1 and this name node 2 having its own namespace, that is 2. Right? Here these two name nodes are actually independent of each other. They are not at all dependent and they do not communicate each other. They only manage this namespaces, right? So here in this name node, you can see, as I told you, the first benefit of this federation is it scales horizontally. You can see it's scaling horizontally, right? Here we also have data nodes. In the diagram we have four data nodes. So we know that these data nodes are actually used to store data blocks, right? If any of the data nodes which are present in the architecture, all these data nodes has to register with the all the name nodes which are available, because so that it will be easy to perform operations. Before performing any operation, each name node has to link with the all the name nodes which are available. You can see here, this data node is also registered with this name node 1 and this name node 2 also. You have we have two links here, two lines are going from data node 1 to name node 1 and name node 2. So this also you can see, this data node has two links from this node to name node 1 and also name node 2. So before performing any operation, all the data nodes which are available has to register with the all the name nodes which are available in the cluster. So this is about HDFS namespace federation. And the next topic is HDFS checkpoints and backups. Before moving on to this topic, let me tell you what is FS image and edit log file. All of we know that name node stores the metadata of the HDFS. Metadata in the sense data about data, like file, the size of the file, who is the owner of the file. Everything will be stored in the name node namespace. In this name node namespace, we'll also have two kinds of files which is maintained by name node, that is FS image and edit log file. This FS image and edit log file, again it's like a metadata only. So now what is the use of this FS image and edit log file? What we store in this FS image and edit log file? This FS image, we store the metadata in the sense, again, like the file system properties and the mapping of blocks to files and the entire file system namespace and like what is the state of the HDFS. Everything will be maintained in the FS image, that is file system image. Here we'll maintain file system properties. In other, there is one more file called edit log file. Edit log file actually maintains runtime modifications of HDFS. Runtime modifications in the sense, like whether if you are deleting some file in the from the HDFS, then that is also modifications. You are doing some modification. That information will be stored in the edit log file. Or if you are adding some file, that is also kind of modification. That information will be stored in the edit log file. Or if you are appending some data into the existing file, again it is a modification. That information again will be stored in the edit log file. Now what is the use of these two? Why your name node has to maintain these two files? Because whenever name node starts, whenever we are starting name node, the state of HDFS, because the state of HDFS will be stored in the FS image. In which state it was in, what are the properties, everything will be stored in the FS image. And whatever the modifications have happened in the HDFS, all modifications will be stored in the edit log file. So whenever we are starting name node, all those changes or all those states can be easily fetched from the FS image and edit log file, because all our information will be stored in the FS image and edit log file. So whenever name node starts, the details can be easily fetched from these two files. And the new state, whichever the state HDFS is in, all the states again will be copied back to FS image. Right? Now we'll see what is HDFS checkpoint and backups. So these checkpoint node and backup node are two different nodes. These are also one kind of nodes, okay, where you can have these two nodes in your Hadoop system. What is the task of this checkpoint node? Why we should have this checkpoint node? The task of checkpoint node is that continuously fetches FS image and edit log from the name node and merge them. And the resulting state is called as checkpoint. So this checkpoint node continuously fetches which one, that is FS image and edit log file, because this fs image and edit log file will be maintained in the name node namespace. So now all the modifications and all the file system properties will be stored in these two files. So now what is the task of this checkpoint node is, it regularly fetches the details which is present in the fs image and edit log file. After fetching those details from these two files, this checkpoint node will merge these two files, that is fs image file and edit log file. So after merging, whatever output we get, whatever the resulting state we'll get, that is called as checkpoint. Okay, this checkpoint will be created by the node called checkpoint node. After getting that resulting state, again that resulting state will be uploaded to the name node. Okay, name node namespace. And the next one, that is backup node. Backup node in the sense, the name itself saying that is backup. It is a backup for the name node. So normally there is a difference between this backup node and checkpoint node. In checkpoint node, this continuously fetches all the details for fs image and edit. But in backup node, it doesn't download any fs image and edit log file. Instead, why? Because it will maintain the up-to-date information of the name node. Whatever the operations are happening, all those details will be regularly will be stored in the backup node. That's why it doesn't download any fs image file or edit log file from the name node. So whatever the details it will get regularly, all those details will be stored in both in memory and disk. We all know that snapshots will be in the read-only mode, where you cannot change anything for your data, where you cannot write anything to your data. It will be in the read-only mode, where you can only read data from the snapshot. You cannot write anything to the snapshot. So you can take snapshot of a HDFS file system, like you can take the snapshot of entire HDFS file system, or you can take a snapshot of subtree of a file system also. Now what is the use of this snapshots? Why we have to take snapshot of HDFS? It's only the first use is data backup. Data backup in the sense, like if for example, if you delete any file accidentally, that file can still be recovered using HDFS snapshot, because that snapshot will be stored in the namespace. If you delete any file, those files still can be recovered because of snapshot. And we can also protect against user errors in the sense, because since it will be in the read, snapshots will be in the read-only mode, where any of the data like within the HDFS directory can be protected. Okay, and whenever performing snapshots, it only copy the how many blocks are present and what is the size of the block. It only take the snapshot of that. It doesn't take the snapshot of data, whatever the data we store in our data node. It doesn't take the snapshot of our actual data. Instead, it will only take the snapshot of block list and file size. And whenever we are performing snapshot, whenever we are taking snapshot, it doesn't affect any other HDFS operations. Like it doesn't affect read operation or write operation. Whenever we are taking snapshot, it will be different thing where you can separately can take snapshot, and simultaneously you can also perform other read and write operations also. Now how to take snapshot? To take snapshot in HDFS, there is a command called create snapshot command. So which creates this create snapshot command creates snapshot of a file system. And this is about HDFS components. Thank you.